A team of engineers and rehabilitators collaborate to test a soft, wearable robot on Parkinson's patients who have difficulty walking. Worn around the waist and thighs, it helps to propel the leg forward to prevent freezing, making walking safer. See how it works on NSF Science now. Parkinson's disease is a neurodegenerative disorder that affects more than 9 million people worldwide. Debilitating symptoms include tremors, slowness, and freezing, which occurs when someone with Parkinson's suddenly loses the ability to move their feet, often mid-stride, causing stutter steps and even life-threatening falls.
Yeah, so in Parkinson's, freezing of gait is really a devastating condition. You know, so it's where a person is either walking or trying to start walking, and their feet feel effectively glued to the floor. And then sometimes that ultimately leads them to being froze in place, or being unstable and increasing greatly their risk of fall risk.
Current treatments, including drugs, surgery, and behavioral therapies, have proven ineffective until now. Finding a solution brought together engineers and rehabilitators to study the gait of volunteers with Parkinson's. NSF-supported researchers at Boston University Sargent College of Health and Rehabilitation Sciences and Harvard John A. Paulson School of Engineering and Applied Sciences have used a soft, wearable robot to help volunteers with Parkinson's walk faster and further without freezing.
Our collaboration with BU is really exciting. So we have engineers, you know, working with physical therapists or clinicians, and also with individuals with Parkinson's disease. So oftentimes the way that we work, it's kind of like a pit crew. We bring in a participant who has a gait deficit, and you know, then we have the entire team there both looking at like what is the challenge that they face with their walking, and then how do we apply some of the technology that we're developing together to try and improve their walking capacity.
The wearable device uses cable-driven actuators and sensors worn around the waist and thighs.
So the way that this works is we use apparel to interface and attach to the human body and cable-driven actuators to apply forces across a person's joint, so in parallel with their underlying biological muscles. And then we integrate sensors into the system that monitor how persons is moving and then tells those actuators or motors to apply forces to those cables at the right time.
Algorithms estimate the phase of the gait and help swing the leg forward to prevent freezing, making walking safer.
I think one of the things that we've been trying to do is develop wearable robots that will be suitable for people to wear in the community and their everyday lives. I think our soft exosuit, you know, is optimized really to be as lightweight and non-restrictive as possible, but then still deliver sufficient assistance to lead to meaningful improvements in walking capacity for people.
Terry Ellis and her team at the Boston University Center for Neurorehabilitation are excited to see the research results firsthand.
We're doing research and providing clinical services all at the same time with all the same people all together, and it makes it, you know, sort of real. You know, we're trying to make a real impact on the patients we serve in the moment.
Ellis's team spent 6 months working with a 73-year-old man with Parkinson's disease, who despite all other treatments, endured substantial and incapacitating freezing episodes more than 10 times a day, resulting in frequent and dangerous falls.
We're in the very early stages of this, but the person that we've been working with has severe freezing of gait. And with our approach using these robotics, we've been able to prevent the onset of that freezing of gait. So it's an incredibly exciting finding, something we're super passionate about. And our plan is to bring in more people and to try this on others.
Participants in the study say the suit helped them walk longer and maintain the quality of their lives. While the robotic apparel is still in the research phase, the team hopes to make it commercially available to help those experiencing debilitating and dangerous freezing symptoms.